Good morning. I greet you this amazing morning in the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. I'm excited as always to have this opportunity to speak the word of God into our lives in the name of the Lord. I want to declare the Lord has been good, he's been kind, he's been amazing. And we lift up his name because of his grace and his power and ability to transform our lives. I want us to pray and then we will hear the voice of the King. Our Father and our God, in the name of Jesus, we bless you this morning. We lift you, we honor you, we glorify you because there is no other God like you, Lord. We want to dedicate our lives, our Father, into your hands this morning. And we are desiring of your presence, your power and ability to transcend through our lives in the name of Jesus Christ. So as we hear your voice this morning, it's our desire and our prayer. You're going to challenge us unto godliness in the name of the Lord. Father, we bow before you, we honor you, we lift you, we glorify you, and we thank you because that which you're about to do in our lives cannot be reversed, and that you continue to lift us and to place us in a place, O God, of your high calling, my Father. We want to commit everybody in your hands. We shall encounter this message. Father, minister to us, glorify yourself through us, for the glory and honor of your name. Father, we bow before you, we bless you, and we lift you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. Praise the Lord and good morning, child of God, wherever you're listening us from. I'm excited because I know this one thing, that God who began a good work in us will be faithful to complete it in the name of Jesus. Now, I want to speak about a subject this morning. The Lord will carry us through. The Lord will carry us through. This is very, very important. I read the book of Isaiah, chapter number 40 and verse number 11. The Lord will carry us through. Isaiah, chapter number 40 and verse number 11. The Bible tells us from the New King James Version, he will feed his flock like a shepherd. He will gather the lambs with his arm and carry them in his bosom, and gently lead those who are young. Praise the name of the Lord. Now, this scripture talks about the attributes of God that are very important for you to understand as you go through the journey of salvation, the journey of our faith. This scripture reveals very, very important things. Number one, Jesus said, God, that whom you have given to me, I have lost none. This is what it means, that God has a divine purpose and plan concerning each one of us. And so when Jesus is taking care of our lives, he's interested to ensure that we remain in the domain of God's calling in our lives. Now, these attributes are very critical. The Bible tells us he will feed his flock like a shepherd. And so God is interested to feed us. Now, when we talk about feeding, it's about growth. God wants us to move from one level of glory to another level. God wants you to succeed. God wants you to rise. God wants you to be blessed. God wants you to prosper. God wants you to expand. The scripture tells us expand the place of your territory. So God says he will feed his flock like a shepherd. Now, this issue of feeding and Jesus Christ as the shepherd means he knows what we should take to ensure our victory, our success, our health, our dominion. When you are a family man and you've got children, you make sure you feed them the food that will make them to grow healthy. So Jesus is going to feed us his flock as a shepherd. Now, a shepherd gives his life for his flock. A shepherd protects, a shepherd guides the flock to the place of, you know, grass that is good for the flock. Praise the name of the Lord. The Bible also tells us he will gather the lambs with his arm. Even those that are young, even those that might be weak in their faith, Bible tells us he will gather us as lambs in his arms and carry us in his bosom and gently lead those who are young. So God is not just looking at the mature. He's not just looking at the people who have got the muscle or the metal to overcome problems or challenges in their lives. God is saying, even for those who are growing up, even for those who are growing up, he will continue to carry us in his bosom. Paul says, my little children, whom I travail yet again until Christ is formed in you. My little children, whom I travail again until Christ is formed in you. Praise the name of the Lord. Now, I want to declare to you this morning in the mighty name of Jesus Christ that God desires that he will make us to grow, to mature, to be the people he has called us to be, to function in his glory, to function in his power, to function in his capacities in the name of the Lord. And therefore, child of God, wherever you are, no matter what you're going through, I come to speak to you this morning in the mighty name of Jesus Christ to declare this one thing, that he that began a good work in us will be faithful to complete it. Praise the name of the Lord. My encouragement to your life this morning is that God will carry you through. I don't know what challenges you face as a believer. I don't know what challenges you face in your physical life. I've come to declare to you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ that God will carry you through. I know there are people who are suffering in sickness and disease. I've got a word for you. Jehovah Elohim is a God who heals us in the name of the Lord. And so healing is your portion. I know there are people who are troubling, are discouraged even economically. I've come to declare to you this morning in the mighty name of Jesus that Jehovah Elohim, our God who is rich in mercy and grace, is going to carry us through in the name of the Lord. I know there are people who seek to know God, to understand his call, his desire, his purpose in your life. I want to declare to you this morning in the mighty name of Jesus Christ that Elohim is going to come through for you in the name of the Lord. And Jehovah God is coming through for my life in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. We shall be saying at the end of the day, look what the Lord has done, because God is going to carry us through. I want to close by saying, look at the Egyptian story. When the people have been released by Pharaoh to go and worship their God, after great miracles God has done in the land of Egypt, the Bible tells us when they got to the Red Sea, there was a problem. And behind them, the Egyptians' army were pursuing them to go and restore them back to slavery. Now, I want to declare today, the enemy doesn't give up on your life. And so when they got here, Moses lifted up his staff, and the Bible tells us that God said, tell the children of Israel today, these Egyptians you see today, you will see them no more. Hallelujah. So God carry them through the Red Sea on dry ground. Hallelujah. God separated the sea and the people walked through dry ground in the name of the Lord. What a supernatural occurrence of God in their lives. This is what I'm talking about concerning your life. I don't know what aspects of your life are troubling. I do not know. But I know this one thing, that God will carry us through in the name of the Lord. No matter the challenge, no matter the obstacle, no matter things that have risen against you, I've come to declare to you that God will carry us through in the mighty name of Jesus. The good Lord, therefore, be with you. The good Lord bless you. May the Lord carry you through. Maureen, thank you for being there this morning. May the good Lord be with you. Good Lord lift you in the mighty name of Jesus. And all those that will encounter this message by the grace of God, may the Lord Almighty go ahead of you in Jesus' name. Shall we pray? Father, we thank you this morning. We glorify you. We lift you. We honor you. Thank you because of the voice of your word. Thank you, Father, because you've given us a promise. You will carry us through. You will feed us and you will hold those that are lambs and those that are young and those that are young. You will gently lead them in the name of the Lord. Father, we thank you. May this word touch our lives in a supernatural way, that this word will just actually fall in fertile ground to help us to be the people you have called us to be. This we pray, believing and trusting in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. This has been your host, Pastor Johnston Sakwa, coming to you live on the Scripture Prescription, your daily morning dose of the word of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. May the good Lord bless you. May you have a day that the Lord is going to carry you through in this season, come out with miracles and testimonies in your life, God sorting out your problem for the glory of his name. Shalom. The good Lord bless you. I look forward to seeing you again tomorrow morning, same time, same place, as we continue to listen to what God has to say for us this season. You are blessed in the mighty name of Jesus. God bless you.